Hey, this is Aubrey, Agee coming at you from AntiGravity Detroit. Today in our vlog, we're going to talk about true value versus perceived value. A lot of times in small black businesses, we worry about our perception to others. And a lot of times, no matter what we do, we will look as negative because of the color of our skin and the stigmas that people hold on to. You can't change them. For instance, I had a job for a very long time where I interfaced with my superior running a program for folks where that individual rarely ever looked me in the eye and looked the other way when we sat and talked. And I tried my best to win that person over with doing great, coming up with great content, running a great program, being extremely entrepreneurial, and they never changed. So you can't change haters. And we just got to continue to go with what's truly valuable, and that's what's inside us and what we bring out to the world in our products or services.
Let me talk about a topic that a lot of us know about. Okay. So, the hardest thing to do is to find value in products and services, and as an entrepreneur, you want to find that value, first of all, foremost in yourself. And when you are trying to get your value out there in the form of a product and or service, you want to be careful, right, that you do the right thing and that you don't skimp out on what you really have to offer, right? A lot of self-doubt, a lot of imposter syndrome keeps people from actually putting their best foot forward. Keeps them from actually shining the way that they could. And in the context of black-owned businesses, it's a challenge as well. A lot of us hold on to imposter syndrome. A lot of us need some kind of validation because society doesn't typically validate black businesses right off the bat. If they do, they're looking at a lot of times as if a black business is a problem. Or they're just bad or poor or just not good enough to begin with. Not necessarily as like a thing where people think. I don't think people think of terms of race or individuals of a certain race as like a inferior, like born that way. But I think it is. I think it's a popularity game that we just have accepted for hundreds of years. And I don't think we really think about it clearly. I think people just want to feel important. So they'll look at those who are underrepresented as just not as good. Because that helps place their lot in life. That helps them maintain their pecking order. And again, I don't think people do it intentionally. It's just like middle school politics. If you feel like you're one of the popular kids, you don't want to not feel that way. So you may not say bad things, but you'll go along with the crowd when they kind of shun or put down the nerds or whatever group that's considered easy prey. So with that said, challenge is, how do you not give in to trying to change people's minds that are stuck in those thought patterns, right? How would you change a person's mind that wants to remain in the in crowd and look upon you as if you're not? I mean, do you have to be, as they gave the example in the movie Do the Right Thing, when I think it was Spike Lee's character was talking to one of the sons of the owner of Sal's Pizza. He said, I think he was straight up using the N-word. He was saying, he was referring to some black folks that that were popular in like Prince or Michael Jordan or Michael Jackson, and the son of Sal was like, yeah, those are great people. They're not niggas. That's what he said. I'm probably butchering it, but that was the gist of it. But he thought of everybody else that wasn't, of Jesus Christ level in their profession as niggas. And I think that I think that's a problem. That may not be the word that runs through people's heads, but it's what a lot of people believe. And that's not just, you can't just say that's white people. That's just the way the world has structured itself after slavery and colonization. So, and you know, people, and a lot of people, there are people, a lot of people have the strength to kind of look that in the face and say, that's not me, right? A lot of people disassociate themselves with being black. I've seen that a lot from folks from other countries outside of the U.S. They do that. And it helps them boost their confidence in not being, you know, they're saying, hey, I'm not one of those kids that's in the unpopular group. I'm different. The reality is, you know, human beings are human beings. You know, the cure for cancer can reside in anybody's brain, in any part of the world. It could be in the brain of a poor kid that lives on the streets of Calcutta. It doesn't matter, right? The goal is for each of us to try to find that value in ourselves and nurture it and bring it out into the world. That's the number one thing. So it's hard to not want to say, hey, I'm not one of those. But I think you draw better and greater strength when you say, I am one of those. I am valuable. I do have this thing that I am nurturing. I am not perfect. Nobody's perfect. But I've got something to offer. And I think that's where we start. So when we're talking about value, it's a thing of true value as opposed to, I'd say, perceived value, right? I think the biggest thing to focus on is true value first. What's really inside you, and what are you willing to really work on to make great, as opposed to making people believe you're great or look great by appearing to be something that you're not, right? You're human. You got something to offer. So this is Aubrey Agee, Anti-Gravity. We're talking about true value today. Have a great day. Have a great week. I hope that if you have questions, and this is more of a philosophical vlog, if you got questions on where do you start first in your business? Where do you first start when coming up with the ideation of a business idea? Please don't feel, you know, feel free. If you want to talk about, if you want to ask questions on accounting or resources that are within the city of Detroit or beyond, or if you want to talk about design, you want to talk about, you know, how do you reach your market? You can ask any of those questions, whatever. We're a total wraparound service for businesses that become our clients. And if we don't have a solution, we'll find it. We're not perfect either, but we're going to help whomever we work with, find their value, and work towards perfection. Thanks. Hey, this is Aubrey Agee, talking to you from AntiGravity Detroit, hanging out at one of the premier tech spots in the city that a lot of people don't know about, and that's Flyball Labs. There's the front entrance. Mac Hendricks is the owner. They do multiple IT services for businesses, schools, and open source solutions as well. They specialize in PBX phones, and they have their own SIP trunk website that manages hundreds of lines. They're pretty amazing. Hey, sucker nigga, whoever you are. Hey, sucker nigga, whoever you are. Hey, sucker nigga, hey, sucker nigga, whoever you are. Whoever you are. Hey, sucker nigga, whoever you are. Hey, sucker nigga. Whoever you are, whoever you are.